So, welcome to Money Talks TV. In this video, we are going to talk about your income. Yes, the money or the cash that enter your pocket every 15th and 30th of the month. What if your income stop? What would you do? So, if you are interested to know what would you do, then please like this video. Make sure that you click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell that will ring you and notify you once I uploaded a new video. So let's not prolong the four words. We will start our hot discussion in this blog. Really, it is a real talk and really, really hot because this will inspire you and awaken your mind for your own future. Also, an eye-opener to everyone. So, let's begin our discussion after this intro. What's up, guys? My name is Manuel Mani Alamra, your Kamani and Kanegosyo. I am entrepreneur, OFW, author, and content creator. Basically, I share business tips, personal improvement, and others. So, let's begin. What if your income stops? Let's say you get fired or you were forced to retire because there are new graduates and younger than us who are ready to take our place. Or the company that you are working went close. As we all know that Eben Shells, which is a giant company, is closing down this day. Like Shells in Batangas, which around 200 Shells worker affected by a Batangas refinery shutdown. Anyhow, that is out of our topic. Let's move on to our hot discussion. What if your income stop? What would you do? As an OFW, call center agent, executive, sales agent, engineers, lawyer, teacher, artist, etc. What if all the cash that enters your pocket every 15th and 30th of the month suddenly and totally stop? Yes, you have the money that the company gave you as your separation retirement pay. Hopefully there is. So you can consume the money till you get old. What if it doesn't reach? Do you have enough savings for your family's daily needs? Do you have a source of income separated from the source of income from your work that will support you and your family? Most of us Pinoy consider our children as our retirement plan. We invest on our children. We send them to school, thinking that in the future, they are the one who would support us financially when we can no longer work due to old age. Most of us believe on this. Even before, our ancestors lived with this belief, which is wrong, definitely wrong. We should never give our children the responsibility of providing us when we get old. So what should we do, Kamani? Well, you have to establish something that will take care of your future. You must create a source of income that will continually make money flow inside your pocket. Start a business. Do business while you are working as an OFW, call center agent, executive, sales agent, engineers, lawyer, teacher, etc. Start a business and master that business till you get out of that company. For when your income stops, at least something will still support you until you grow old. Don't depend to others. Make your own well of money. Even if it is small, it is your own and you will not depend on your family and other people. So, shout out to those parents who are under the care of their children and being passed on from child to another, and also to those adult children who are dependent from their parents despite of their capability to earn a living but chosen not to. Shout out to all of you. So, going back to our discussion, start a business now. I don't care if it is a barbecue store, ukay-ukay store, multi-level marketing, networking, or sari-sari store, etc. Start now because your experience here will teach you what to do in the future. It's so hard to struggle in business when you are 60 years old during after your retirement. You have to create a source of income separated from the source of income from your work. That when the time comes that you have to start working, you will have your own source of money. Start a business that will be there to support you and your family. I am not telling you to quit your job. I am telling you to start a business while you are working and stop spending your money on liabilities. Start putting them on asset. You know, that's what I did. I started my business while I'm working as an OFW. I created asset, I lessened liabilities, I invested, and I learned. Then I'm in business. I know what you have in your mind. You have to enjoy what you work hard for. Yes, that is right. But think of something that will last. Think of your future. I have seen the worst of people who work for a big companies, earn a fortune and got a big retirement pay by the millions. Now, it's gone. Why? Because of their mindset. Let's say you retire at 60 years old and you have 5 million pesos. But you will still live in this world until, or let's say, 80 years old. Like my father, now he is 80 years old and thanks God, he is still strong and no maintenance yet. Do you think that 5 million will support you for another 20 years in your life? Of course, all of your children has their own families that time. And they can no longer support you because their priority are their own family. I need not to mention some athletes, actors, actress, singers, ex-OFW, etc. Where they are now. Next, after acting, singing, playing, and hard work. Anyhow, to those who will ask, what business? Well, any as long as you think it is feasible or your passion. Myself, I get into a food business and rental property business, even though I don't know how to cook. And it's out of my field. Why? Because everyone eats. Whether they rich or poor, they eat 3 times a day and sometimes 4. Right? This is not to brag, but to inspire everyone. My restaurant, commercial store, drop shipping, and my farm businesses were there that will support me and my family once I stop working here in abroad as an OFW. By the way, I'm looking for a business partner for my restaurant business. Of course, those who know how to cook. Just comment down below to those who are interested. So, I am proud to say that all my businesses are original and all are grand asset. I started all my businesses with a very small capital while I'm working as an OFW here at Saudi Arabia. You know, of course, so many times I failed to my business journey. Really? But I did not stop. Why? Because I developed the qualification, skill, behavior, character, and qualities of an entrepreneur, which was shared and you can watch it at my YouTube channel. And the link are provided in the description below. So, shout out to those entrepreneurs all over the world. I salute you guys. So, I hope I inspired your thought for your future. Please comment in the comment section below if it is right to do a business or start a business while we are still working and master that business till you get out of the company. As always, thank you for watching. If you like the content of this blog and you learned something from this video, like and share so that YouTube can be recommended this video to those who is looking for this kind of information. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. Make sure that you click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell that will ring you and notify you once I uploaded a new video. Once again, I pray for your success and safety in whichever corner of the world you are in. And see you again on my next video.